Recent research has shown that upward mobility is systematically higher in some neighborhoods than in others, and that moving to a high opportunity area improves children's outcomes in adulthood. Yet, the vast majority of low-income families in the US live in low-opportunity neighborhoods. This is true despite the fact that nearby high-opportunity areas often have similar or lower rents. So, what prevents families from moving to opportunity? One possibility is that they prefer to stay in low-opportunity areas because they are attractive on other dimensions. These could include shorter commutes to work, or stronger social ties to family and friends. Alternatively, families may want to move, but simply face too many barriers to do so. They may not know which neighborhoods are high opportunity, or lack the money and resources necessary to navigate the search process. This paper uses a randomized controlled trial to test between these two explanations. The authors evaluate the impact of reducing the barriers faced by low-income families in the Seattle and King County rental markets. Mirroring the broader nationwide patterns, this area exhibits substantial variation in children's rates of upward mobility, and low-income families are concentrated in lower-opportunity neighborhoods. While median rents tend to be higher in high-opportunity areas, there is considerable variation in upward mobility, even conditional on rent. In other words, there is scope for families to move to affordable neighborhoods that would provide their children with better opportunity. To evaluate what kinds of policies can facilitate these moves, the authors focus on a sample of 430 families who applied for and were issued housing vouchers, which provide rental assistance to low-income families. Half of this sample was randomly assigned to the control group and received standard briefings on how to use their vouchers. Families in the treatment group received the same briefings, but were also offered a supplementary program called Creating Moves to Opportunity, or CMTO. The CMTO program consisted of three components: customized search assistance, landlord engagement, and short-term financial assistance. The first provided information about high opportunity areas and offered assistance in preparing rental documents and conducting the search process. The second involved contacting landlords to expedite the lease-up process, and the third provided financial assistance to help cover security deposits and application fees. In all, the total cost of the program was around $2,660 per family. And the results show that CMTO dramatically increased moves into high-opportunity neighborhoods. While only 15.1% of control families leased a unit in a high-opportunity area, the analogous figure was 53% for treatment families. Importantly, these moves were spread across a diffuse set of high-opportunity census tracts. This minimizes the risk that any given location experienced a large enough change in neighborhood composition to dampen the benefits of moving there. The authors also show that CMTO did not affect families' propensity to move. In both treatment and control groups, 87% of families used their voucher to find housing. The key is that, conditional on moving, CMTO changed where families decided to go. These figures show that treatment families who moved to high-opportunity areas do not appear to have made sacrifices on other neighborhood dimensions, such as distance to their prior location or the quality of the unit they rent. Indeed, there is substantial persistence in the effects. Families induced to move to high-opportunity areas by CMTO largely choose to stay after their initial lease comes up for renewal and report high levels of neighborhood satisfaction. These results suggest that barriers to moving to high-opportunity areas, rather than a preference for staying in low-opportunity areas, play a large part in explaining the residential segregation we typically see. The authors estimate that the moves from low to high-opportunity census tracts induced by CMTO will increase average undiscounted lifetime incomes by $214,000, an increase of 8.4%, for children who move at birth and stay in their new neighborhoods throughout childhood. So, why was CMTO so effective? Were there specific elements that were particularly important? From a policy perspective, understanding why this program worked is crucial to determining whether and how it can be replicated elsewhere. To help answer these questions, in-depth interviews were conducted with approximately 80% of the study sample. These transcripts not only provide greater context for each family's residential history and background, but also for understanding the particular barriers they faced in moving to opportunity, and which components of CMTO were most useful for addressing them. And the key lesson that emerges is that CMTO's success hinged critically on its ability to respond to each family's specific needs. While the full suite of services was offered to each family, CMTO staff customized the program according to particular circumstances. While some families relied heavily on search assistance, others used more financial assistance or took greater advantage of the landlord referrals, and this flexibility was crucial to the program's success. Consistent with this, the authors show that CMTO was substantially more effective at increasing access to high-opportunity neighborhoods when compared to standardized policies with similar goals. In conclusion, this paper shows that barriers to moving to opportunity contribute to socioeconomic segregation, and that those barriers can be overcome with policies that provide short-term assistance in the housing search process. While further research is required to determine whether they generalize to other markets, the results of this study suggest that redesigning certain features of affordable housing programs can go a long way toward addressing residential segregation and intergenerational income mobility. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related research. These include a large and growing body of work on the role of place in driving intergenerational mobility and inequality, studies of policies aimed at facilitating moves to opportunity, and extensive research in both economics and sociology on the causes of residential segregation.